Gunslinger is taking on the high-tech Bangkok City team. Now, this is the second meeting for both these teams, but Bangkok winning the first encounter 59-51. That was over at their place. A lot of has happened, of course, since then. Bangkok is ruling the roost with a perfect 7-0 record, while Singapore sits in third place with a 6-4 record. Bangkok boosts the league's best scorer and big fan, Chris Charles, averaging 22 points a game and 10.7 rebounds, along with outstanding defender Steve Thomas. Singapore counters with Kyle Jeffers, the low post force, and a plethora of talented low players as well, including Dior. And we'll talk more about Dior Lawhorn a little bit. This is action from last Friday week, and it was all one-way traffic to this point. Smith giving it up. That man right there, Jermaine Johnson, rolling through two of his 22 points. Kyle Jeffers in the open court, crashing his way through two defenders. Singapore would go on to lose this game by 10. Too much stuff like that. Uninhibited through the basket. Smith rolling through the basket, and they hold big enough to drive a truck through. No outside defense either. Coach Cho talked about just what happened last week in that loss. 88-72, the Warriors over the Malaysian Dragons, and then the Saigon Heat. Well, they defeated South Sumatra, who still to win a game. Confirmation of the games today, the Westport Malaysian Dragons are going against the revamped Indonesian Warriors. They won three games now. Confirmation of our game today, the Slinger versus the high-tech Bangkok City team, again at 7-0. Looking at the standings, high-tech leading the league 7-0, as we said, followed by the Westport Malaysian Dragons 5-3. Then come in the Slingers at 6-4. Saigon at 500. The Warriors, yeah, they're getting better at 3-6 from South Sumatra. On the snide, 0-8. So we look at the Singapore Slingers. They've got it all to do today. A lot of us are rest on the shoulders of that man right there, Kyle Jeffers, who has to be forced to the low post, along with Russell Lowe and other people as well. Russell Lowe, what a revelation he's been. Al Bagheera, the 34-year-old veteran point guard, he will be running action for the Slingers. Now, we talked to Coach Cho before the game just to get a sense of what happened on that momentous day Friday a week ago against Indonesia.
Defensively, I think we did a very sloppy defense and let them have an easy open shot. Their percentage is higher on the 3 points as well. On the game is about 41%. That really killed us on the ball winning defense. The way defense bring us through the game. So if you get yourself ready, know what's happening on defense, then you adjust on offense. Because we are running team, we want to run, so we get secure on defense, get a stop, and we just keep running.
The high-tech Bangkok City team, he said, undefeated, and they have a couple of big forces that the Singapore has to do with. Chris Charles, 7-footer, he's 33 years of age, in excellent shape, averaging 22 points a game. What about that name there? Last year's Defensive Player of the Year, Steve Thomas. Played at Middle Tennessee State in Georgia. Now, we talked to Coach Raha before the game started about how they expect to stay undefeated against the Slingers here.
Well, again, we have to control the big man, like Jeffers, of course, and the new addition, which we try to review all the videos, especially in the last game of the Slingers over here. So, But definitely we're going to still our quest this season is to let our locals play major role for this season. So we have lots of plays that the crowd will be seeing tonight, and most of those plays are for our local players, especially our number 4 and 5 players.
Pumped up Singapore Slingers team in white there. They're being introduced. And the Bangkok team, the high-tech city team, they want to stay undefeated. So just about ready to get underway. When we come back, tip-off here at the OCPC Arena here in Singapore. We'll be right back. down with Chuck Schwein along with Michael Vaughn. And Michael, the starting lineup for the Singapore Slingers today.
It's very interesting to see that we actually have three big men on the court right now. So Coach Neil is trying out with the big men, putting Dior on the three spot, hoping that he will lure out one of the big centers from Bangkok and open up the lane for the rest of them to open lane to slash the basket.
I notice that they've got Desmond Oh in the starting five. He is probably the best defender amongst the guards. Look at the lineup for the high-tech Bangkok City. Kanyeda, what a hit, the winning shot the other night against Saigon. Then another local, Jason, he's had a great season. Stephen Thomas, that's him, averaging 8 points a game. And of course, Chris Charles, lightning rod of this team, averaging 22 points a game and about 11 rebounds. So all the play for here for Singapore is they're desperately trying to make up ground. It was too bad for them that they lost that game against the Warriors. They would be sitting pretty if it was not for that. But right now, not much margin of error, Michael, for Singapore. They will stay in this race with a chance to win it.
It was a poor defensive effort last week, so for today's game, I think emphasis will be on the defensive end. Whether we can contain their guards from slashing to the baskets and then dishing it out to the open shooters on the outside. And then whether we can secure defensive rebound. They have two big men down there, so rebounding will be a key point to look for in this game as well.
Chris Charles stands at 7 feet even. Stephen Thomas at 6'8", toil for Middle Tennessee State. Had a forgettable year at Georgia. Get into the specifics of that, but they're a bona fide player here in the ABL, and they're just about ready to get it on here. Charles going to jump it up against Kyle Jeffers, Singapore in white, Bangkok in green, and we are just about underway. Pretty good looking crowd here, still filing into the OCBC Arena. The ball controlled by Bangkok. Kanyeda, the ball scribbles out of bounds, and see whose possession it will end up with. They're saying white ball, both teams. A little bit of indecision right away by the referee, so going to the trail official, Coach Leo off the bench pointing in front of him, which would indicate that it's Singapore's ball, but however, Kanyeda will inbound it for Bangkok. So we'll see what ought to be interesting also, Michael, is how they rotate both Thomas and Charles in the high and low post right now. A double high post looks like. Good rotation on the ball by Bangkok. The ball in the hands of Dasson. Giving it up. Charles behind the screen fires up a long shot. Back to Zetlin, along with the rebound. Back to the Slingers. Lohorn out on the high post, goes wide. Now he goes baseline. Desmond Oh. Flashing across again with Lohorn. 10 on the shot clock. Patient Singapore attack. Knocked away. 6 on the shot clock. Jeffers will go one-on-one with Thomas. Stop the clock. That wins that one. One and out. Ball picked up by Jason. Now going to Jason. Bounce pass inside to Thomas. Gives it up quickly, back outside to Dasson. Dasson to Thomas again, has a mismatch. Wide open, look for Charles, can't get it to go. Offensive board, Dasson. Press 24 for Bangkok around the screen. Goes Kanyeda, Kanyeda back outside. Rolls to the basket, got it. Nice ball movement there by Bangkok. Chris Charles with a finger roll to finish.
Chris Charles would be a big problem, pose a big threat to our defense because he's such a big man and he takes the outside shot. Evidence by the first shot, he took a three-pointer, so that will draw out Jeffers.
Shot to the hole by Lohorn. Back comes Bangkok. Good attempt to shoot action to the left side. He'll get another offensive board by Dasson. Back out to Thomas, he throws the screen on the left side. Inside the middle, Thomas, the third offensive rebound, so third chance attempt now for Bangkok on this possession. Thomas working against Jeffers, knocked away, good defensive effort by Kyle Jeffers. Back he comes, cross-court pass to Desmond Oh. He'll wait for Jeffers to get back in position. Off-balance shot, no good. Rebound taken down by Thomas, his third board already. Bangkok very quickly back with the stuff. Weak side help. Russell Lowe having to come over and a little bit of a mismatch there. So very quickly, Bangkok showing their prowess in the open court. Another look at it.
Bangkok is a team that loves to run as well. So it would be a very good matchup for us to be running and maybe running as well.
Ill-advised shot there by Russell. Very quickly, back comes Kenyatta, giving up the jaw. Got the mismatch inside by Wong, who can't stay with the big man. And a quick timeout for Singapore as they trail 6-0. So, Chris Charles, though, comes back as advertised. Three rebounds also. We'll be right back after the timeout. Basketball so far by Bangkok. Going to the basket, get it out of here. And that is a reason why Stephen Thomas, Michael, leads the league in block shots, over 4.5 averaging per game. That's number one.
The point guard is a very big inside presence for Bangkok. No matter on offense and on defense.
Mid-range jumper from the side on that right side by Lohorn is off the mark. Singapore still looking for their first bucket. Charles, good ball rotation to that other side. Dason Kenyatta loses his defender. Stop, box. Over top, gets the roll off the glass. 8-0 Bangkok. Make that 9. They're going to give him a 3 for that. Quickly back down the court comes Singapore Wong, asking for movement. Up pops Russell Lowe on that right side, throwing the screen. Over the floor. Jeff Lowe way off the mark. Good hustle defense by Bangkok again. Now on the run, Kenyatta will wait for numbers. Thomas on the high post. Running a double high post, rolling to the basket. One and out. Wong racing down the court. Puts two defenders off the mark again. A tussle for the ball. Last touch by Singapore. Breakneck speed this game so far, Mike, but it looks like Bangkok getting the better of it. Another look at Wong trying to split two defenders. And as his shot partially blocked, last touch by Singapore, they're going to say. We said these two teams met about a month ago in Bangkok. Bangkok came away 59-51 winners in that game. Great ball rotation. Skip pass in the middle. Picked off Wong. Back the other way. He's got Jeffers ahead of him. Gives off to Jeffers. Off the backboard and in. Left hand off the glass by Jeffers. Singapore on the board. Woody Pong dash off Boston Signal. Overload on the right hand side. Rolling off the screen is Dasher. Charles, high post. Rolls to the basket. Stops underneath. Dasher from the reverse. Yeah. Beautiful pass by Charles.
It seems like Bangkok has a pretty good chemistry between the local boys and the Nippon. They've been making a lot of back door cuts, and that's something they should pick up for.
Russell Lowe, the ball is on him. Has the ball knocked away by Thomas. He'll wait, give the ball up to his guards. On that right-hand side now. Kenyatta. Navarro getting lost in the shuffle behind the Charles screen. A shot, no good. Rebound Jeffers. Jeffers gives it up to Al Vergara. Great anticipation, almost knocked away. Wong gives it up to Jeffers, who grinds, can't get the ball. Russell Lowe with the rebound underneath. Two defenders on him. Vergara looking for room. Gets the ball down to Lowe. Now to Jeffers. Well, brother, Jeffers. Good job on the rotation on the half-court game by Singapore. Finding the open man. Jeffers obliges. He's got 4. He the only person on the score sheet for Singapore thus far. They're under 4:29 to go here in the first quarter. Low scoring affair. Charles wide open. The second missed shot. Ball in the hands of Wong. Pressing the action. Looking against Pineda. All the room in the world. Back wins that one. And one rebound again. Throwing behind Charles. Overcomes Wong. Can't knock it off. Pineda now. Inside one three. Steps it back out to Daza. Daza underneath. Oh, yeah. Baseline. Drop step move. Hurtatar Daza. Here it is. 13-4. All one way traffic for Bangkok. One quarter. The guard. Other side, Jeffers. Lack of ball movement. Wide open look, but way off the mark. And Jeffers, no choice there. Michael, as the shot clock is running down. Back to Bangkok. Thomas gives it up. The trailer. That was Jason. Can't get the layup to fall for it. Russell Lowe. Joe for two. The guard around the three by Lowe. Looking for a little bit of space. Down low now. Jeffers. Thomas playing in. Russell Lowe again from the outside. Lohan had it. Now he still has it. Turns the fires. No dice. Back from Bangkok. First offensive board for Singapore. To take up against it. Working against Lowe. Oh, beautiful turnaround move and a foul.
You move, what?
That'll be on Russell Lowe, Michael, and Charles taking Russell Lowe to school on that play. Beautiful little spin move.
I think I'm trying to run with every single possession, hoping that create a mismatch like what you've seen just now. The big man running down the court fast and looking for him. Once they get a mismatch, they pump the ball in and then they let him go to work. And as a result, the transition offense.
Charles coming as advertised. Chris Charles leading the league in scoring, averaging 22 a game. He is the whole package. We see him hit from outside, inside. Great passing skills. He can rebound. Very high basketball IQ from what we've seen so far. Checking in the game now for Singapore, Unghan Bin, number 6. Desmond Oh will take a seat. Sort of a glazed look in the eyes of the Singapore Slingers. If they've been hit by a train. 14-4 now, 10-point game. Biggest lead of the game for Bangkok. Wong with the ball. Lahorn camped out on that high post on the right. Jeffers having to come way up high. Thomas doing a fantastic job on it. Long three is off the mark. Charles gets a hand in there. Knocked away. Kaneda on the move. Bounce pass to that right side now. Charles now on the low post. Thomas up high. Now they rotate. Double high post to throw the screen. Kaneda working on Vergara. Finds a breeze. Back outside again. With a stubby step move. Charles Jeffers. Finger roll up and in. Wingspan on Charles. On full display right there. 16-4. Slingers have 4 points. 2 minutes to go in the first quarter. Around the screen. The ball is going to play off the mark. One and out. Rebound by Fortier. Checked in. He's averaging 4.5. So Bangkok giving everybody a little bit of playing time. Thomas gets into the ball. Fight for the rebound. Last touch. By Singapore. No, check that by Bangkok. Over the top. A timeout call by Bangkok. They are thoroughly dominating Singapore here in the first quarter, making it 16-4 off the timeout by Bangkok. So we'll be right back here to the OCBC Arena.
right, and this is where the girls. And teams back on. Your teams back on to
on the long shot line here at the OCBC Arena to get all Bangkok City. They lead Singapore 16-4. Singapore seemingly no answer, at least early on. Just relentless attack and on defense also by Bangkok doing a tremendous job.
You're right, Bangkok was really good defensively. They were disrupting a lot of our plays, making steals, and they forcing us to go into a one-shot, one-rebound situation, and leading out to their offense.
Great job on the interior. Look at that. Another example of what you were talking about, Michael. Every time Singapore tries to take the ball to the hole, it's knocked away. Taken away. So long story short, one and out. Too many of those. Singapore with 4 points. Jeffers. That's a three. So the first triple for Singapore. That cuts the lead to 16-7. Singapore's going to have to find a way to get inside. Inside. Double team there by Thomas back out. Nice help there by Rohan. That ball's off the mark. Rebound taken by Jeffers. That's three for him. Long pass down the court. Oh. Backs it up. Puts it inside to Rohan. Rohan, double team. The ball knocked away by Thomas. Second block of the game for him. Back to Bangkok. That's Jerome, number 13, who checked in the game for Bangkok. Just reset, Ryan on the shot clock. Trying to pick up the foul. Going to be off the mark. Rohan with the rebound. And the pass to Russell Lowe. Gets it back outside the long. They'll play for the last shot. Spreading the offense out just a little bit. Up top, Ryan goes down low. Jeffers, two on the shot clock, now balance inside and throwing it away again, and that will do it. So at the end of one quarter, High Tech Bangkok City takes 16, Singapore Slingers 7. Right after this, as we look at Coach Yeo, who is a little bit behind himself. Trying to figure out what to do. We'll come back and see if he solves it in a moment. For the Slingers, in fact, only two people in the books at all. Jeffers with four, Hunt with three. That was a three-pointer. Another one being hoisted up there. Well, court. Long with the rebound. Tries to kick it back outside. Green shirts everywhere. Ball in the hands of the guard. Another green hand comes in.
Lohorn. On again from three off the mark. Rebound ripped down again by Bangkok. And here they come. Great movement without the ball. Charles is going to come up to supply the screen. He's got the ball. Left hand dribble. Rotates inside. Ball on the floor. Picked up by Wong. Cross court over to Bedara. Bedara looking for Jeffers inside. Knocked out the high post. Lohorn trying to get loose. Being fronted underneath by Jensen. Still Lohorn. The kick back. Now Lohorn turns. Fires with the right hand. Still can't get it. Gets his own rebound. Finally, second chance attempt for Singapore. They trail by 7, 16-9. Running the offense now. Also in the game is Montien still. The Bangkok doing a good job of switching up their guards off the screen. And Ron shot no good. He passed to the guards in the open court. Oh, gets off to Lohorn, and he is half from behind. Good job of anticipation by Alvador.
I know we ran the two we had a lead out run for the fast break.
There's the foul. This is an area of the game that Singapore is going to have to pick up as well. They were horrendous at the free throw line against the Indonesian Warriors 9 days ago in that 11-point loss. So they've got to clean it up. Lohorn in that maiden game of his for the Slingers had 18 points. Kasim lost defensively. One out of two. So a 6-point lead now for Bangkok. For full court pressure employed by the Slingers and a touch foul by Vagar in the back court. Reaching in. Bangkok will get the ball out of side. So for the guard position, Montien number four is for Bangkok. He said. Also Thomas getting a blow. End of the game now is Gokar. He's averaging 4.1 points a game. Gavi Gokar. Again, running that same system. Flashing across the middle, setting screens without the ball. Wide open look from way outside is no good. No one will let that play out. And Singapore will come back. Good opportunity here, Michael, for Singapore to make some inroads into Bangkok since they were rushing some starters.
It's a good opportunity for them to run some plays like what we're seeing right now. We're not going to expect them to come to a drive. We've got Thomas inside. Inside presence is not as strong as before. We should try to take it to the basket.
Ran that play off the screen. Wide open look. Get back outside. Knocked away by Lohorn. Here come the Singers. 3-on-1. Yes! 2-point game. The finish by Vagara. And Bangkok forced to call a timeout. So Singapore wrapping it up on defense, getting a couple of steals and making Bangkok pay for a little bit of sloppy play. We can get a chance to see that again. Here we go. See right there, the 4-on-2. Easy two for Singapore. And that's the way to do it. As we said, Singapore has got to take advantage of these times. Bangkok started resting their starters. Coming all the way back from 16-7, a little 7-0 run. Laid in the doorstop of Bangkok, who no doubt will counter putting their number one team back into the game. 7:26 to go here in the second quarter. That's more like it.
I think the Singapore players are getting used to a bit of the Bangkok defense because they're trying to overplay every single game. So right now, it's a better opportunity for us to go back door and go straight to the basket. But with Thomas coming back on the next timeout, I think we have to make some adjustment on the second pass or the third pass to get another teammate open.
So even when Bangkok took their major players out, in other words, Thomas to the bench, Kasim to the bench, and these all scorers with 7, they still play the same style, as you said, Michael, the overplaying on defense and a little bit sloppy, not executing on defense the way their first team did. And Singapore immediately taking advantage of that, picking off 7 straight points to get right back in this game. Good effort by Kyle Jeffers. getting a steal. Lohorn also taking advantage of Thomas not being in the game.
All right, let's do you.
Back up Bancroft. Kanyeda back into the game. Checking in Bandit Lockdown, number 12, averaging 3.6 per game. Dasa back in the game also, as is Thomas. So we'll see if Singapore can make some adjustments. Little turn and shoot by Dasan. Wow. Instinctively knew where the basket was when he turned. The lead back up the floor. Lagarde looking for Lohan. Charles on him. Lagarde. Jeffer is bumping off the two defenders. Thomas having a hustle to keep up. There's a shot by Wong. That will count as three. So Singapore back to within one. Singapore doing a good job making switches on offense that time. Charles. Thomas. Picked up by Hunt. Lagarde now with the ball on the right side. He bumped a little bit. Jeffers can't get at the ball. Forcing the action against Kanyeda. Left hand. Hung on him. Knocked away. Good defensive stand by Singapore. Lagarde. Lohorn. Out the ball with the lead. Singapore with the lead. 19-18. So the cutback is complete by the Swingers. Kanyeda throws the ball away. See, last touch by who? They're saying last touch by Singapore. The crowd can't believe it. Well, I don't know about that call, but anyway, Bancroft's going to get the ball back. Unless one of the referees can overturn that. Charles, little hesitation move, rolling off of Jeffers, back outside. Can't get it. Thomas, last touch by Thomas. How brave is that one in amongst the trees? Getting position underneath the basket and outbiding Thomas for that rebound. Back comes Lagarde. Jeffers, around the screen. Comes Kanyeda. Lagarde playing hide and seek with him. Wong. Off the mark. Thomas with yet another rebound. Back comes Bancroft. 5:19 to go here in the second quarter. Knocked away by Jeffers. Lead pass to Lohorn and picked away. Nice play by Thomas. A little bit sloppy play here. Dasan. Back to Kanyeda. 12 on the shot clock. Good switch off on defense by Singapore, but slapped by Kanyeda. Well, off the screen, Kanyeda gets all alone, so good job of recognition by Bancroft on that possession, losing the defenders. 2-point lead now by Bancroft. Quick pass to Lagarde. Singapore shooting much better from outside, forcing the defenders to come out, and the floor by Lohan. Tied at 21. Michael Wong, all it took was Singapore hitting a couple shots from outside, forcing the Bancroft defenders to come out on the shooter, opening up some space inside for Singapore.
That's right, we just need to get a few outside shots, and then opening up the lane for us to go slash the basket, and then running some back doors as well.
Charles gets his own rebound, powered by Kyle Jeffers. Singapore held to 7 points at the end of the first quarter. They trailed 16-7. Furious comeback by them. Long three is going to be off the mark. Rebound by Jeffers. Gives it to Lagarde. Singapore dominated the second quarter by Bancroft in the first. Charles puts the lead ball up on the floor. Lead pass. Kanyeda. Charles loses it. Last touch by Kyle Jeffers. Good play by Jeffers to get back. Top action on both ends. Lacan with the inbound. Kanyeda gets it over to Lassange. Charles almost loses it. ball still on the floor. Last touch by Bancroft. Nice hustle on defense by Singapore. Both Jeffers and Wong going after the ball. Charles pops it up. 3:43 to go. Tie game here at the OCBC Arena. I hope you're enjoying this one. First place Bancroft. City team, High Tech Bancroft, leading the league with a 7-0 record, going against the third place Singapore Slingers at 6-4. They made up their place about a month ago. Singapore on a losing end of that 59-51. Inside, Lohorn, back out. Charles is on him. He took out again, knocked away. Vidaro reaches in. Six on the shot clock. Wide open, Lohorn! Well, that's the eclectic nature of Lohorn's game, Michael. He can play in or outside. Pineda, Wong looking on him. Kick back outside to Gasol. Off the dribble. Little hesitation move. Charles with the follow. Can't get the ball. Jeffers looking on the rebound. Vidaro. Overload on the right hand side. Low on the line. Both. Now inside, double team on Jeffers. Somebody's got to be open. Inside the lane, Jeffers. Oh my! 26-21. Singapore forces the action. Canada. Ball working on him. Off balance shot, yes. Last and four. Lead pass, ball again. Inside, throws the ball away. Singapore in a little bit of a hurry that time, but what a second quarter for them.
Both teams are playing at a neck-breaking pace. I wonder how much left in the tank will they have in the tank at the end of this game.
Wong with 9 points, Lohorn with 10. The other side of the ball, Charles with 7. Deson with 8 and a travel call. So Bancroft, because of the defensive pressure being employed by Singapore, a little bit out of sync.
The Slingers definitely have upped their defensive intensity, and then this is creating a lot of problems for Bancroft as well. Slingers cannot handle Jeffers and then locals with Jeffers being bodying him up really strong. It's very hard for him to get inside presence or inside advantage on them.
Much better movement by Singapore. They're bigs, rotating high and low. Lohorn doing an excellent job down low. Long three is going to be off the mark. Tipped out and picking it up is Lohorn. So a fresh 24 for Singapore. We approach the 130 mark. Lohorn finds Vidaro. Up to top arm. Now they switch sides. Long for a screen. Instead, he finds a double team. Lohorn, 5 on the shot clock. Ball for a long three. Oh, my goodness. Unconscious. Unconscious. 10-second triple. Singapore up by 6. Russell. They take over to Dasson. Loses one defender. Not long. Great play by Hong on defense. Vidaro underneath. Lohorn. 31-23. Great step by the Slingers. Spotting the open man. Lohorn, no hesitation at all. He's taking it straight to the hole. There's a two by Canada. So 33 seconds to go. About a 9-second differential, good shot blocking game clock. Wong, Lohorn, brings it across and is Wong. Lohorn on that left side, fires up a goal! 34-25. Undertaker at the score, Bancroft will play for the last shot. What a turnaround of this game. Off the dribble, there's a foul. That's it's unfortunate for Bangkok. So they'll check it in with 1.3 to go. Charles catch and shoot, going to be off the mark, and the swinger will go into the level with a 34-29 lead. They trail by 9 in the quarter, they lead by 9.5, an 18-point turnaround for the swinger. So Lohard leading the way by 15, on 9, on 6. We'll come back and break it down for you further after this.
You may just win a raffle ticket for two and $5 of teleportation plus $5 cash to be used in New York, New York.
Dribble by Basem.
again on that other side there. Jason Wong with the baseline. In the open court, Wong with the give on the trailer. Finally, Singapore scoring. This is early on in the first quarter. Nothing to shout much about. If you're a Slinger fan, they only had 7 points, as we said, in that first quarter. Now the Singapore starting to ratchet up in that second quarter. There is Ung. Now that's still in the first quarter, actually. They started to turn around very quickly in that second quarter. Lolo takes it up his own business following it. Another look at it there. Terrible job of boxing out by Bangkok there, allowing him to step through the lane to score. McGar with the give inside. Oh, beautiful give and go off the screen. That was Wong Wei Long, leading all scorers. Well, for the local guys with 9 points. There it is on the break right there. Wong again. The 4-0 break finishing up. Check it out again. 6 turnovers for Bangkok in that first half. Only 4 for Singapore. And the difference comes from Wong. Singapore taking advantage of these turnovers to the tune of outscoring Bangkok 10-3 in points off the turnovers. Another look at it. Twisting and turning in the air. Lohorn, he leads all scorers with 15. He also has 5 rebounds, 3 of them offensive rebounds. So second chance points, which were invisible for Singapore in the third quarter. How about big for Singapore in quarter number 2? There's Wong again off the dribble. A little finger roll in the lane. The 2 of his 9 on the break again. Magara, he packs. Lohorn right there getting behind Stephen Thomas. Another look. So check out some of the stats that are important. Michael will let you take it from here. Some interesting stuff.
The Singapore Slingers actually up their defensive intensity right at the second quarter, and it coincides with the time where Bangkok actually went to their bench. So we took a momentum swing, and then we capitalized on it. With the starters, with Bangkok starters coming back, we were still able to ride on with our momentum and then carry it out through the end of the first half. And that results in a 9-point lead for the Singapore Slingers.
21-19, those are the rebounds. And we got an interview with Chris Charles. Chris Charles, as we said before, a mainstay on this Bangkok team. We asked him several questions, but what makes him so successful? What is his work ethic about here in Bangkok?
After practice, also, I attribute a lot of it to my teammates just finding me in the right spots and coach drawing up plays for me to get the ball in the right position. And just continuing to do the same thing every day, routine.
Okay, Bangkok is undefeated thus far. What do you attribute your team's success to?
We got a lot of good local talent. The guys, you know, we got a good group of young guys and then some experienced guys. So just the experience and the young guys coming together and having a great, you know, just teamwork, mind frame, and sharing the ball, and just understanding that, you know, every game is very important, and we don't want to take, just because we're undefeated, we don't want to take that, you know, get too carried away with it. Just take it a game at a time and continue to play together.
Okay, then you said in an interview that Bangkok is the favorite city that you have played in for your career. What is it about Bangkok that you like so much?
Bangkok is just, the people are very friendly. You know, they call it the land of smiles, Thailand. And I just love the atmosphere. It's very affordable, the food, just the lifestyle. People are very laid back. It's just a place where I really find my niche. Outside of basketball, I feel comfortable there with the people. They're graceful, they're graceful.
And through a rigorous off-season training program, as a matter of fact, at the Denver Nuggets training facility, it's an NBA facility, and you credited that in one of your interviews with motivating you for this season. What specifically do you do as far as that training goes?
First, I have to give credit to my best friend, Randy Foy. He's a shooting guard and point guard for the Nuggets. He really, you know, he took me in under his wing and just showed me some things that on that level that they work on. And basically, he just was showing me, and their trainer, they were showing me things just to how to prepare your body. Not so much heavy weights, but like a lot of resistance bands and body weight and basketball-specific exercises and dietary things. And just some of the small things behind the scenes that you really don't take into account, but it's very important as the season progresses. And Randy and the guys with the Nuggets, they really showed me some important things that I tried to carry over into my game.
The last question, a lot was said about your relationship with Steve Thomas, who ironically is now your teammate. How has that worked out for both of you so far this season?
Last year there was a lot of talk about me and him having beef, but it was just us being, you know, heated competitors. And whenever I played against Indonesia, it just was bad boys, and they were very fiery, you know, and I took that personal. I just wanted to, you know, compete. And he's the same way. He's just he's a warrior, and I'm proud to be able to have the chance to play with him. He has his game speaks for itself. He's proven in this league, and he's a stand-up guy. He sacrifices a lot of his game for the good of the team, and I always respect him for that.
So, Chris Charles, a very articulate young man, and speak about Chris Charles, he's leading the league in scoring before this game, averaging 22, followed by Jones. 20, almost 21 points again. Eversley, we've seen him, 19.38. Jermaine Johnson from Indonesia, 18. Knox also his teammate right there. Those are your scoring leaders. How about the lead blockers? Justin Williams, 5 blocks a game. There is Chris Charles again, 4.5 blocks a game. Kyle Jeffers, 1.6. Jermaine Johnson, we've seen all these guys. Tremendous shot blockers in their own right. So we're going to break away for a little bit. Slingers leading the high-tech Bangkok City team 34 at the halftime. We'll be back to break it down a little bit further and get you ready for the second half after this. OCBC Arena here on the top score of your game. Dior Lehorn leading all scorers, Michael, 15 points. Wonga with 9, Hung with 6, Jeffers with 4 on the other side of the ball. Pretty much static in that second quarter. Bassam leading the way, 8 points. What is really conspicuous by his athlete, Thomas, no points. Charles has 7 points at the end of the first quarter. He's got 7 points now.
All right,
really, really a great job shutting down this high-powered Bangkok offense has been averaging well over 80 points a game.
Jeffers has been doing a very good job being very physical with Chris down low. He should continue with that in the second half to ensure that he doesn't get in position to attack. And as for Thomas, he hasn't been getting any advantage down low. He's been battling really hard. So that he's been doing a very good job on him.
Off the dribble, momentarily losing it is Jasenov. Jasenov inside, knocked away momentarily. Nice hustle play by Kyle Jeffers. Last touch by Jeffers. 4 left on the shot clock. So Bangkok in trouble early on here with their first possession. Checking it out will be Dawson on the right side. Hines. Talk about some of the game inside the game activity. Points and turnover. Singapore 10-3 in that first half. Points in the paint, 18-14 for Singapore. That is a stat that is tremendous to me because one would think that Bangkok, the best rebounding team in the league, would be way up there on that. Charles with the turnaround. Oh, it sticks up into the pin between the glass and the rim. So, no joy for Bangkok in that first possession. Second chance points, Singapore 7, Bangkok 2. So all the stats within the stats going Singapore's way. A little bit of housekeeping duty going on underneath the basket where Jeffers and Thomas hit the floor. Then we'll be underway. Lehorn really seems to have meshed in the Singapore offense. We saw him about 9 days ago and he looked like he was a little bit lost. But now he is right in the thick of things and one of the go-to guys on the Singapore offense. Rolling off the screen. Oh, look at this. Rolling to the basket with Wong. Can't get it to fall. Kenyatta off the dribble. Switches hands. Begala on him. Jeffers and Thomas going at it. Lehorn bumping with Charles. Off the mark. Lehorn, great defense to stand by him. Begala. Lehorn. Oh, my goodness. Taking off from the free throw line. Dior Lehorn. How do you like that? 11-point lead now for the Swingers. Dawson. Thomas again out wide. Bangkok tries to spread out their offensive set. Dawson again inside to Thomas. Knocked away. The guard at the ball. He fouled in the backcourt. Singapore now missing the beat here in the third quarter. What a play by Lehorn. Check this out. Taking off one step beyond the free throw line. Cupping the ball. Knocked away. Last touch by Jeffers, who obviously was not expecting that pass from the guard. Working on him, he's done a good job on him. The second quarter, Jorginator, Charles, big play step, yeah, up and in. Very nimble move there by Charles. Going around Lehorn, risking his body. Here's on. Jeffers, back to Wong, waiting for movement. On the game behind the screen. Shot away on the mark. Thomas there for the rebound. Back to Kenyatta. Bangkok down by 9. Another shot off the screen. Got to cut down. Off the screen thrown there by Thomas. So Kenyatta brings Bangkok to within 6. Lehorn to on. Wong running the baseline. The guard trying to pick his way through a screen and a foul down low. I think Charles was holding on.
sweep.
Rohan tried to run the baseline. Charles stepped in his way. I think that's two fouls yep. now on Charles. Checked out one for his first time. Nobody really in foul trouble right now. It's been a very clean game, Michael, from that perspective. Vidara. Rohan on the low post. Jeffers behind him. Oh, yeah. Great job running against Cañedo. First step, the 34-year-old, leaving him in the dust. Juan still working on Cañedo. Again, Bangkok straightening it out. Thomas trying to pull up the three. Ball picked off. Back comes Jeffers. Can't get the ball. And gets the rebound. Ball, double flag. Got it. And ball. Somebody is down. Let's see who that is. Kyle Jeffers, I think. Two Singapore boys down and Jeffers holding on to that foot. Let's hope it's not as bad as it looks. Kyle Jeffers grinding his pain on the floor. Singapore now up by 10. Under 7 minutes to play. They can hardly expect to keep this team by Kyle Jeffers. Let's look at it again. Jeffers lands awkwardly. You can see that right there. Holding his instep. There's the ball by Long. But it might be costly, Michael Long.
That's bad news for Singapore because if Kyle goes off the game with his sprained ankle, it will be a devastating loss to the Singapore Stingers because down low, we only have Russell who's going to come in for Jeffers, and it's going to be a very big disadvantage for us.
Jeffers still in very obvious pain, holding on to that instep of his foot. I don't know if it's a foot. Here comes a medical team right now, and they're not playing around. They're coming right with the wheelchair. So I think that might be it for Kyle Jeffers tonight, but what it looks still. So Russell Lowe will be asked to come in and fill the shoes of probably the hardest worker on this Lakers team. A guy who's been heart and soul for this team the last 3 or 4 years. My goodness, look at him. I guess it's the angle, but look, he seems to be more holding the top of the foot. You almost wish at this point it is the ankle and not the top of the foot. You hate to see something like this happen to anybody, but see, and there it is right there. You can't really see. Watch it come down. Lands awkwardly on that foot. So it might be the ankle, and it doesn't look good. I don't know if he landed on Long's foot or he just slipped. And, I'd be very surprised if we're going to see Kyle Jeffers back tonight, Michael.
Reaction for at least to this game. He looks like he rolled ankle badly. He's holding on to it. Look at his face. He's focusing on pain. I think he'll be back.
All right, let's go, Slingers!
So Russell Lowe will have to pick up the slack. So good news, bad news. The good news, Singapore with a 10-point lead. And at the line is Wong to try and make it an 11-point game. The bad news, they've lost their workhorse. And from the looks of it, he won't be back anytime soon, at least in this game. So just when you thought everything was going Singapore's way, devastating injury, and it doesn't matter if you're a Bangkok fan or a Singapore fan, you hate to see something like this. Singapore has had their share of injuries this year. Hassan Adams, who has since left Singapore, and how about Larry Liu dislocating that finger? He's still 3 weeks away from coming. And now, many would say the heart and soul of this team, Kyle Jeffers, leaving the arena in a stretcher. So not good news at all for Singapore. So, Russell Lowe, all eyes on him. So Wong at the line. Let's see if that takes the air out of the sails of Singapore. Missing that, Charles got the rebound. Back comes Cañedo. Let's see if they go straight at Ruffalo. He's watching Thomas. Charles coming over to help on defense on the weak side is Lowhorn. But as we suspected, going straight at Russell Lowe.
The guy inside presence of Howard. Yeah, Bangkok needs to go to the basket or else because there will be any legit shot blocker at the moment.
Wrong. So that'll mean that it is in the hands of the outside shooters a little bit more for Singapore. Nice fake. Off the mark. Rebound by Lowe, fighting for it, still fighting for it. Hong comes down, back outside, first 24 for Singapore. Nice hustle play by Russell Lowe. Off the dribble is Magara. Lowe throws the screen, inside, Lowe, shot block. Thomas and Charles collide. Onto Lowe. He gets past Charles, and they foul. Charging foul, of Charles. Forearm to the body of Lowhorn. Turnover. 5:48 to go in the third quarter. Singapore up by 8. If you just joined us, devastating loss by them. Kyle Jeffers removed from the game. Appears to be a serious ankle or foot injury. Low. Long three is good. That's 12 for him. Check that 14 for Wong. Singapore back up by 11. DeSena. Now Thomas. Conversion on him, they double team. Foul will go on Al Bagara with the reach in.
Al
Bagara. First foul on him. Bangkok will take it out on the baseline. Dawson. Way up, balance. Oh my goodness. Almost falling out of bounds. A long three for Jason. Low. On. The guard. Back outside to Wong. Lowhorn lurking on the left side. Wong off the dribble. Eight left on the shot clock. Little finger roll. Can't get the ball. Back the other way, Bangkok, they got numbers, 5-on-4, Jason, I thought about it. Kenyatta, short, rebound, taken by gets it into the hands of Wong. Singapore will take their time. Russell Lowe at the high post. Lowe being forced to play low exclusively now. Thomas all over him. Lowe being asked to move, but Gar with the shot from outside, no good, Charles with the rebound, one and out. Kadeda, Dawson, off-balance shot, a foul. Can't get it to go. Russell Lowe picks up the foul. A little bit more quickness in the step of Bangkok now, obviously without Kyle Jeffers in the game. They are getting the ball down as low as much as they can. And then when the defense slumps off and tries to take up the slack for Jeffers, they kick it back out. And last time it worked for them was just on it, knocked down the three from the left side.
Bangkok is looking to drive every single time to the basket, hoping to take advantage of the situation for Singapore Slingers. But knowing Singapore Slingers, you know, they've overcome adversity ever since the start of this season. So they're going to do it by committee. I believe they will do it with defense, tenacity, effort from every single one. And then I will be able to contribute.
That's what it's going to take. Now the lead trimmed to 6 points. Singapore led by 11. And Jeffers went down. Off the dribble inside, Lowhorn. Tries to force it, could get it to go. Rebound by Jar Canada onto the races. Slips in between, one defender. Yes! And one! Jared Canada switches over to the left hand. Pedro Slim to respond. Foul goes against Russell Lowe. That will be his score. So a chance now for Bangkok to climb to within three. Well, it didn't take Bangkok long to go to work on the interior. So 43-40. Almost walked again. Arm gets trapped on that right side. Overloads on the right. The ball goes in. A pop arm. Logan's over delivered.
covers the screen. Inside look, foul. That'll be on Thomas, I believe. If it's Charles, that would be three on him. Let's see who they get.
I think they want it to Thomas. Second, substitution.
Thomas still scores in this game, but not in this game.
Like getting all these loose balls, defensive rotation, blocks, and rebounds. So his job in this game is not really to score, but really to be doing all the dirty work.
Of course, what the Slingers are hoping is to hang on in this game and then check the status. Perhaps it'll come out worse than it was. We don't know. We'll get you updated with the injury report soon as we do know. Can Rayo again Singapore back up by 5, 3:42 to go in the third quarter. Thomas throws the screen, rolls off of that. Charles for 3, off the mark. Thomas with the follow. Fourth ball for him. Charles with the follow and a foul underneath. Nice job by Charles. Stays in there. Gets Lohorn off the board. Lohorn with 19 points now, leading all scorers. Tornado leading the scores for Bangkok at 13. Fresh 24 for them. Charles. Turning. Can't get that to fall. And with the rebound. One and out for Bangkok. Back comes Bagara. Switches to the left hand.
Lohorn.
Right side, no good. One and out. Charles gets it to Tornado. Throw it pass. Picked off by Desmond O. Sloppy stuff by both teams. Bagara looking for a lane. Russell Lowe kicks it back outside. Desmond O. Back out to Lowe. Lowe to inside. Bagara can't do it.
That's good.
Two layups in a row. Lohorn missing. Tejeda. The kick out. Frenetic pace in this game right now. Minion giving it up. Charles scoops it up. Foul. I think that'll be on Russell Lowe. That'll be three on him. So Lowe now in a little bit of foul trouble. Desmond Gold will check in. Desmond missed the last game here against the Warriors due to the balloon. So getting his first taste. And it couldn't come at a bigger time for the Singapore Slingers. Charles, two shots here. Charles now to 12 points. 5 of 16 from the floor. 12 rebounds, and he misses the second one. Stepping in the lane.
What?
Is Thomas. Let's see how they rule this. I think it's going to stay with Bangkok a foul. Wrapping up, they say. So, Thomas at the line again. Gave that foul to them. I think it might have been on Ung. See, he's got two now. So driving on. Ball tipped up. Singapore gets it in a foul. Late whistle by the referee. You can quite clearly see Thomas reaching in. Unlucky there for Singapore. Looked like Wong was off to the races.
Yeah, it was a good foul on Thomas' part, although he didn't mean to.
45-42, Singapore. Without Kyle Jeffers, fighting for dear life here. Holding on to that 3-point lead. Make it 4. Wong now with 15 points. One, two, Charles. It up.
to Dawson. Back outside for Pineda. And again, Bangkok going to that spread out offense, trying to create space for their big men. Go working on Thomas. Let's see if they go to him. They got a mismatch inside. Around the screen, long three, no good. Thomas with another offensive board. Just back outside. Just 24 for Bangkok. Under 2 minutes to play here in the third quarter. Other side. Montune in the game. Long three is no good. Go with the rebound. Back comes Singapore. Quick pass. Low arm. Nice little turnaround. Move. Got it. And more. The foul will be on Charles. That'll be three on him. Great little drop step move by Bohorn. Look at him on the baseline. Charles. Well, two choices. Let him go or not. And Charles makes the wrong decision. So back up to a 6-point lead by Singapore. Lohorn now with 22 points. So a timeout by Bangkok. They're going to have to talk it over. They made some inroads. They led by 10, Singapore did, after the 11. Now they lead by 7 for the timeout. 49-22 will be the back. little bit of desperation showing on the faces of the Slingers. They've got to figure out a way to hang on, get out of here with a win right home. Now, but the good news, bad news is, yeah, they don't have Jeff Lee, but the good news is, after this, they do have about a week off. So, supposing that the Jeffries injury isn't as bad as it looks, we don't know yet. Then perhaps if they can get together and get a win today, what a boost it would be to them. Right now, it would be tough for Singapore. And as you said, the substitutes like Dennis McGough, these people are going to have to do what they've got to do to keep Singapore in this game.
It's interesting to note that Coach New actually employed a zone defense at the end of the third quarter, and it was actually quite effective. So we've got to see whether at this fourth quarter, is he going to employ the same strategy against Bangkok.
Del McGough, not Dennis McGough, excuse me. Pineda, off-balance shot, yes! From the elbow, a turn and fire, and Singapore's lead is 10-1. Good job by Benny Clark to get back. Jerome working on Ong, now they switch sides. Lohorn operating the high post. Delvin Go at the low post. Now he jumps up to apply the screen. Five on a shot clock. Off the glass, can't get it. Thomas with the rebound. Bangkok's opportunity here to go ahead. Pineda working on Desmond O. There's a screen by Thomas. Thomas all alone rolls through the bucket. One hand jumper is good in the lane. And there is the lead. So Bangkok, mission accomplished all the way back from 11 down. They now lead by one. And Singapore calls a timeout. Coach Neil wiping his brow. He's got to come up with something. Singapore back on their heels when we come back. Coming back to take the third quarter, 23-17. Most of the damage done after the injury to Jeffers. Lohorn kicks the ball back outside, and he rumbles in, back out to Vergara. Singapore without Jeffers in there, having a hard time getting the ball inside. One and out again. Rebound taken by Gokar. Tineda will wait for numbers. We'll put the 8-30 mark in the game. Back outside, Thomas has the trailer down. Nine left on the shot clock. There's the screen. Strong trips over that, off balance shot. There's the top, cleans it up, puts it up again. And again, Singapore, Michael, being exposed on the inside.
We've got hard tackles. It seems like our defensive rebounding is at a loss. Right now, Thomas is doing whatever he wants down low, and he's grabbing a lot of offensive rebound. He needs to be footbacks.
Lohorn, Thomas working on him, running him. Off the dribble, and Lohorn turns, fires off the mark. Gokar back from Bangkok and Pineda. Pineda working on the guard, has to give him space. Now Thomas again. Lohorn working on him. Mid-range jumper is good. Well, that's the problem. Lohorn, not a perimeter defender, really. Thomas, who was scoreless, now has nine. So he has benefited the most. Jeffers going out of the game. Another one and out. Rebound taken by Gokar. same old story. Pineda, Prodi, gets the ball inside, knocked away. Long, they've got numbers, 3-on-2. Madara, blocking foul. That'll go against number 13, Perron. Well, that's a 50-50 call there. Could have gone either way. Madara lucky to see it get his way. There again is that play. Here's a gentleman's play earlier on, and obviously landing very awkwardly. I couldn't tell by that if he landed on another player's foot, or he just hit a wet spot on the floor, or he just landed awkwardly. But irregardless, it is what it is, and Singapore is going to have to play without him for the rest of the game, and who knows, maybe sometime in the future as well. Still waiting for confirmation on what that injury was. Line for Vergara. Bangkok up by 4. Conawad in the game right now. Coach Raha spoke highly of him, getting it to go, stepping through that line, throws it away. So a turnover. Let's see if Singapore can take advantage of that. In the game now for the Slingers is Wu. Another guard. And Singapore trying to make the match the best they can. Three guard offense. Up comes Russell Lowe. Remember, Lowe with 3 fouls. Madara. Wu. Shot in the lane. It's good. Singapore with a big chance. Back comes Kenawan. Trying to back pass on the block and the process. Nice touch defense by O. Fast pass inside. Kick back outside to Montian. Montian looking in. Knocked away by Lohar. Long three off the mark. Rebound by Vergara. 6:03 remaining and a foul to the backboard. That'll go on number 13, Perron. Silly foul. I think there was some confusion. The horn now. See the players looking up on the horn. Thomas getting ready to get back into the game with 6 minutes to play for Bangkok. So he gets less than a minute. Looking pass knocked away.
Back to defense.
Picked up by Dogar. Ball hands now Perron. Under 6 minutes. Charles, way off the mark there, knocked away. Last touch by who? That Bangkok will retain possession. Unlucky there for the Slingers. Here comes Thomas back into the game. Pineda also follows. So, last 5 minutes and 43 seconds. Bangkok reloads. Out of the game goes Vergara. Vergara 3 points, 5 assists. Pineda looking at the ball. A beautiful play by Charles. Nice spin move. Leaving down the goal in his wake. Leaves back up to 4. Oh, around the screen he comes. Lomar on high post. Looking for help. Gives it to Wu. 7 left on the shot clock. Wide open. Wu will take this for 2. Won't call for him. Stepping in to try and get a rebound. Take it away. It goes. Thomas comes away with it. Thomas now with 15 rebounds. Same as Charles. Rebound 43-26 by Montego Bangkok. Charles. Yes. Did he get it? Yes. And 1. My goodness, and rolling right past Russell Lowe, process. Great move down on the low blocks by Charles. So a chance to make it a 3-point play. Vergara, check back in. Desmond over, check out. Charles a little bit slow to get up, but he's okay. Yeah. Just a devastating turn of events for the Slingers, Michael. And, you know, you're not thinking what might have been. And you hate to harp on one player, but Kyle Jeffers really is the heart and soul of the Singapore Slingers. Without him, it changes the way they play.
Kyle Jeffers brings a lot to the table, as I showed in the defensive end. With no shot blockers in the post, he's just a banker. Has a free lead to basket every single time of day. The way they shoot the ball is like telling us that like, no one's going to block the shot, I'm just going to make this shot every single time.
Under 4.5 to play, Bangkok leads by 7, they've led by as many as 9, there was no hurry now. Kenyatta. Gadot, Magara, 3-on-2, Magara still has it. Goodness, golden opportunity there for Singapore. If Magara finishes that, that's a 6-point opportunity. So he will go on the line and have to earn it the old-fashioned way. Coach Nyo, here we go again. There's Magara, the reaching by Kenyatta. So 4:08 to go, 6-point lead now for Bangkok.
Coach Nguyen has gone into a 2-3 zone as of the last possession, and then caused some confusion in the Bangkok side. That's why coughing the ball up and then leading to our fast break. So I believe we will go into 2-3 zone and this is the end of the game and see, you know, whether we can disrupt. Make Bangkok shoot some threes, make them hit some shots. You know, if they can't, we're going to get the rebound, we're going to run on them. So we'll see how it works.
Swarming defense by the Slingers, almost worked there. 6 on the shot clock. Good move underneath by Thomas, the follow by Charles. Second tip, no good. Charles still with the ball. Has it knocked away. No foul. Away to the cup, long. 3.5 to go. Lohorn with the ball. Gives it up, a foul. That will go on Dawson, and that will stop the clock for Singapore. And let's see if that puts Lohorn at the line. So Singapore, as you say, going into that 2-3 zone, sort of daring Bangkok to hit their outside shots, trying to even up the odds a little bit in the interior. Lohorn with the ball, knocked away. So he coughed it up, knocked away again. Thomas right there to clean it up. 3:20 to go here in the game. Charles. Little drop step move, spin, knocked away, took back outside. Right shot to Billy Garnett. Lohorn comes away. Still Lohorn in traffic. Foul. Kenyatta, I think, with the touch foul. So that will put Lohorn at the line. And again, Michael, Singapore, 58% from the line, 7 of 12. Bangkok 7 of 10 for 70%. And another miss. Well, down the stretch, you hear it time and time again how important it is to hit the free throws. Singapore, last 2 home games have been unable to do that. 1 of 2, 5-point game now.
Let's get strong.
Bangkok used to close games. They beat Singapore by 8, 59-51 at their place. Last 2 games they won by 6 and 5. They're up by 5 now. Charles, Thomas, Kenyatta. Stop and pop on that left side. No good. Magara. Singapore off to the races. Pass over to Lohorn and he fouled again. So Charles now with 4 fouls. And that's a strategy by Bangkok. I mean, the Singapore's not going to get their free throw, but he might as well foul.
On the other end, Thomas knows that he has a 2-3 zone, daring them to shoot the 3. Until now, Bangkok has not actually made any shots on the outside of the perimeter. So it's a good strategy, and we actually got 2 transition offense on our end, and resulting in 4 free throws. We just need to make this free throw to make this a game.
So a chance to trim it to 3, and that's exactly what happened. So the last 2 minutes, 30 seconds on the feet. 4-point pressure by Singapore. Charles with the ball now, you'll wait for number. Kenyatta. Spread out the offense again. Singapore stays in the 2-3 zone. Charles, the snatch, no horns on him, goes to the basket. Little finger roll, gets his own rebound up and in. And another example without Kyle Jeffers on the inside. Pretty much free range for the big for Bangkok. A foul. That'll go against number 13, Perrone. Which again stops the clock. For Singapore at the line again with 2:10 to go. The guard only one of the more consistent free throw shooters for Singapore.
Kingston.
10 of 17. So they've missed 7 free throws. With a traveling defense. Charles picks it up. Singapore racing back. Everybody converging on Charles. Still in the 2-3. Back outside. Long cross court half. Wide open look for three. Way off the mark. Charles can't corral that one. Begara, long lead pass. Roar! Yes! 2-point game. And a timeout by Bangkok. What a job by Singapore on the defensive end, picking up a loose foul. Getting the ball back down the court. Rohorn, great balance in the air, Michael. Up and in off the glass. 63-61. You know, you can sit and talk about what if this, what if that, but look at this last play. We talked about the little things that Singapore were going to have to do if they were going to prevail, despite the injury to Kyle Jeffers. Great example of a miss. Three players going for the loose ball, picking it up, spotting the open man. We look at the leading scores for Singapore. Lower now to 27, more than 15, on 6 for God, 5. So Singapore need a stop here.
The new results actually working perfectly for the Singapore Stevens right now. Bangkok has not hit a three yet, like I mentioned before this. They have not put down their role, their shooters, and they are not comfortable shooting a three. They have been actually quickly pass the ball down low and looking to get a three shot. So with a long shot, long rebound, it's easier for the Stevens to walk in transition. It's not an easy basket like the one you saw just now.
Russell Lowe, the enter of the game for the Slingers. So it'll be Wu, Begara, Wong, Lohorn, and Lowe. Bangkok, Perrone stays in the game for them. So in that double, Gasson, Charles, gives it up to Kenyatta. Kenyatta, the guard will work on him. He can't afford playing too closely. Looking at Charles. Current fires, can't get it to go. One out, Singapore, with a chance to tie it up here. Charles are very tentative on that shot. You're right, Michael. They don't feel as comfortable away from the basket. Begara, 1:23 to go. Wide open, good ball. Passes it up. Blocked on the other end. Wong, an opportunity to shoot at Mike, and for some reason he held up on the clock. Thomas, he's going to be back outside. Kenyatta, Charles. Rohorn on him. The kick out, 7 on the shot clock. Thomas, working against Stone. The bottom end of runner is good. And a timeout by Singapore. 100 minutes ago. Not a bad job of defense by Russell Lowe. Just a very determined play there by Bangkok. And that breathing room that they needed, they had to score there. It looked like the momentum was turning over. And out of nowhere, for once in this quarter, they get an outside shot.
That was a tough break for Slingers. One rebound had the open. open shot, a mid-range shot, something that he's been hitting all day. He turned down the shot, go drive to the basket, resulting in a block.
That was just the other end. Yes, Wong, 15 points, 6 of 19 from the floor. That would have tied it up. So this whole game seems to, fall on the lines of what if. Well, what if Kyle Jeffers doesn't get hurt? What if Wong takes that shot right there?
On the next possession with Bangkok in foul trouble, England should really look to drive to the basket, maybe make use of the horn down low or to go straight to the basket, hoping to get a foul, stop the clock, get the free throws, triple the lead back to the one ball possession.
So Singapore is going to have to run it down and get a quick basket, get a stop and come down again. Against a very determined Bangkok team, this has been an excellent game. Singapore, a lot of fight in them. Even after Kyle Jeffers went down, but after work cut out for now, Lohorn gets away from Charles. Thomas with the rebound. Under a minute to play. Kenyatta working against Lohorn. Piazza. Running to the other side. Charles inside, stop. Can't get it to fall. Rebound. 30 seconds to go. Zagara looking for room. Back to layup. With the middle. 65-63. 22 seconds to go. And a quick timeout.
Well, Singapore
is doing what they can do. Another timeout, this time by Singapore, so I want to draw it up.
20.3 to go.
So they'll cross it over. But then the people obviously run something off the screen and try and get open from an outside shot. If you're Bangkok, Michael, you give it the deuce. What you don't want to do is foul the shot. Still, they would have a one-point lead, probably looking at 10 to 12 seconds to go. So diametrically opposed strategies here down the last 20 seconds in Singapore, trying to free up somebody for a three. Your Bangkok perhaps giving them the two, knowing that you'll get the ball back.
Yes, Bangkok will be looking to chase the shooters off the three-point line, hoping that they grab the basket and funneling them to Chris or Thomas on the inside. And then on the speakers, the Maria will be running along the screens for all the shooters. Maybe, I think they might consider putting four smalls, four shooters, and one Lohan on the inside. Even Lohan can shoot the three, so it will be like probably like five out to spread them out and then get some shots. We'll see how Coach Neo handles this.
See on the other side of the ball who stays at home. See if they can afford things coming out. The shooters for Singapore. Thomas is a little inside rebounder. Well, what a game it's been. Full of highs and lows. The first set, two quarters were thrown. Bangkok came to play over with a 16-7 lead. Singapore coming back with Benham in the second quarter. It appeared to be pulling away until the injury to Kyle Jeffers. So here we are with 20.3 to play. There's Magara on the screen. Lohan up high. Wong. Back away! Wong comes away with it. 10 seconds to go. The three! Off the mark. Lohan! The shot! Yeah! Oh, my goodness! Oh, my goodness! 6 of these, 5 seconds to go. Turn away. Singapore ball. Still 4 seconds. Can you believe it? D.R. Lohan, Kirk Greensfield, leading back. And then Bangkok on the inbound play. Throws it away.
Just 4 seconds.
4 seconds to go. Singapore with the inbound. See if they get the shot. And they foul. That's the deal. That will go. We go to overtime. 5 more minutes of action. D.R. Lohan hitting the shot with 4 seconds to go. And the third attempt for the Swingers to set this game into overtime.
The second of the fans wild, you're looking at it.
Wow. What a shot, the song all over. Never say die. So, we go to overtime, 66-66. We'll be right back for overtime. 5 more minutes to go. Don't you dare go away. We'll be right back.
Singapore will inbound it with 5 minutes to go.
Let's go, Slingers!
Here is overtime. Can you believe it? Wong off the dribble. Charles with the rebound.
Kanyeda.
Wong coming back and working on him. Again, Bangkok go to work. Singapore still in the 2-3. Looking back, knocked away. Last touch by Singapore, they say. Russell lowered the game by playing the four fouls.
Punch it in.
An amazing 50-32 rebound edge for Bangkok. It's almost even at the end of the half at 21-19. Half with the opposite side. Look into what do we have here? A holding foul. That will go against Wood. We saw the mismatch, so he was fouled.
That was on Russell Lowe, and he's out again.
Yeah, you're right. That is Lowe for Lowe 5 fouls. So Go into the game. Delvin Go. So now Bangkok's turn to be a little bit tentative at the line. 8-13 now. Make it 8-14, and Go skies for the rebound. Back in the paint, are still tied. So they got to put up there, Wong. Lowhorn, looking around the high paint, now he switches to the opposite side. Go steps up, throws the screen, Vergara screen. Got it! Out of the goal. Great screen by Delvin Go. Thomas working on Go. Gets it back outside again. Thomas again. Got him in a reaching in foul on Al Vergara.
Foul routine going in the second.
Lowhorn talking to rebound Low. I think a thrown defensive assignment. Admonishing him for not rotating over. So another opportunity here. Finally, somebody makes a free throw. Whittapan Dawson. 15 points for him in this game. Make it 16 and a tie the game at 68. The bottom. Kanyeda working on him. On top spot. High post is Rohan, and he'll roll off the ground in a moment. Still Vergara. Saved, knocked out of bounds. Nice play by Wong.
Oh, that was a hit-stop play by Wong.
Great recognition. Giving it off the legs of Charles to save the possession. Only four on the shot clock. Curious rally by Singapore at the end of the game to send it into overtime. Wide open look off the mark. Over the rebound. Second chance opportunity. Into the hands of Vergara. Lowhorn working on Thomas. Still Lowhorn. Now Go. Trying to get around Charles. Can't do it. Lowhorn will take the shot. Will be off the mark. The follow. Oh, no. Power boxing out by Bangkok. Pushed it through. 7-58 Singapore. 3 minutes to go. Just happened to have his foot there. The referee whistles him, but watch it again. There it is right there. We did nothing to impede him. But look more than anything else. That Dawson just tripped over Wu's foot. 1 point game.
It was a top foul on Wu, and that's his third foul. You gotta be very careful. He's been providing valuable minutes ever since he came on the court. He had two backs, a few hustle rebounds, and then get a few more extra possessions for the Slingers, which is doing really well.
Drew has two offensive boards. 4 points, 2 and 3 from the floor. One up on the Slingers, that pop through. He's got the ball now. Working on Bassett, bounce back over to Rohan, who gets rid of it. Rolling up off the screen is Wong. Thought about it. Ooh, almost being good. Drives the lane. Back outside. Four on the shot clock. Nagara going to have to do something with it. Get it at the burger! Oh, my goodness. Al Nagara. Go back. Off balance. 3-4. 2-4 lead by the Slinger. Charles with it. Loses the ball. Nagara got it. Back comes Singapore. Down to the 2 minute mark. Still Nagara. 11 on the shot clock. Wong looking for a screen. Rohan on the opposite side. Go with the ball inside. Has the ball blocked by Rohan. Bangkok with the ball. Pierrot gives it up. The three off the mark. Right into the hands of Go. Singapore will have the ball with 1:30 to go. Bangkok needs a stop here. One. Eight on the shot clock. Go for body the screen. Low one. Inside. On balance, and he's fouled. So Dior Lohorn will go to the line. The foul on Pierrot. His three green shirts converge on him. An opportunity now for Singapore to stretch this lead with 1:15 to go. Kyle Jeffers must be smiling now. Some of the Slingers players, the towels over there. Big miss there. Lohorn needs to make this one. Russell Lowe has fouled out. 1-2. So Singapore gets a stop. 4-4 Russell Lowe in the backcourt. Along with Braun, they break the pressure. Davis, and that's all the screw beat. Kanyeda barking out signals. A long three to tie it. The follow is good. Dasan, good offensive position on the board. And another home board. Under a minute to play. Singapore up by one. Bangkok knocked away. Nice hands in there by Kanyeda. 16 to go on the shot clock. Wu will check it in. Singapore. Charles, but the foul! And that will be 4 on Charles. He can't believe it. So, that will send Wong to a free throw line, Michael Wong. And also stop the clock at 48.1. He's still in anybody's game.
These free throws are huge. They need to make this 2 free throws to put it into a 3-point lead.
Start to take place if Singapore can make this and get a spot. 2-2. 3-point lead for the Slingers. Bangkok gets by the 4-4 pressure. Charles with the ball. Dumps it down low. Still Charles behind the screen. A long three. Right off the mark. Singapore with the ball. 35 seconds to go. Opportunity now for the Slingers. Remember, Bangkok undefeated this year. Singapore led by as many as 11. Bangkok led by 7 in the third quarter. Nagara dribbles it up, he'll hold it up. Foul by Charles. And Charles is gone.
And he's fouled himself out of the game.
So Chris Charles will foul out of the game with 29 seconds to go. So that is huge for Bangkok. So each team losing their, arguably their best player, that evens things up considerably. We look up on the scoreboard, it says 5,000. That is 5, that's the indication that the score is taken. So, well, now, some might say that's justice.
It's a really interesting turn of events. Now that we're even on the on paper wise, we need to move this free throw. So I think it boils down to free throws at the end of the game.
Check it back into the game for he's in the third quarter and has some time in the second quarter as well. Now, Singapore, if Agar can make both these shots, it ought to be academic. 4-point lead won't get it, but 5 might. How big is Al Bogart in this overtime, Michael?
Yeah, he made 2 big shots and got a steal out of 3 possessions.
That leaner in the rain to keep Singapore in the ball game. So 4-point lead, make it a 5-point lead. A timeout called by Bangkok. 29.5 to go. Singapore needs to hang in here for another 30 seconds or so. And they will hand Bangkok their first loss of the season against all the odds, Michael. With Kyle Jeffers gone, you can sort of see the air go out of the crowd. But they have hung in for dear life. They teed that when they were down by 7. A furious charge in the last couple of minutes. And overtime, they've been simply magnificent.
They've been really good on the defensive end. Maybe because Coach Neil has made a very good call. Go in the 2-3 zone. I think the Bangkok shooters are out of sorts. And then with the long shots, like I said, long shots, long rebounds, and then slammer swingers run on it and get a lot of transition offense out of it.
Bangkok 4-16 from beyond the arc, 24%. Singapore 7-19 for 37%. So quite a comeback compared to Friday a week ago when Singapore came in here and absolutely couldn't hit anything. So pretty good turnaround for them. Altogether 27-77 for 35% for Singapore. 28-74, 38% for Bangkok. Free throw shots to keep it out now. The last couple of possessions, Singapore has hit their free throws. So both at 67%, Bangkok with the ball. And let's see how Coach Bill has his troops play this. Bangkok with a quick score. Thomas. Kanyeda. Thomas with the screen. Kanyeda. Thomas now. Oh, wasting a lot of time. Knocked away. Thomas still. The first double shot. He hits it. He hits a huge three. Wow. See if that's a 2 or a 3. I think it was a 3. Yes, it is a 3. So Thomas a chance to get Bangkok to within a point. My goodness. Check this. The foul by Zagara, touchdown. Oh my goodness. 17 seconds to go. Wow, not over yet.
Just when we see Zagara is doing all the right thing, he made a run. Foul.
There's a miss. That one. Nice play by Goh to box out. Singapore maintains a slim 2-point lead. 16.8. Hold on to your hats. Singapore will have the ball. And of course, if you're Bangkok, you want to foul as quickly as possible.
Yeah, they definitely tried to go for the steal on the inbound pass, and then if they do get it, they're going to foul the KD.
So, Thomas. Coming up big, hitting a huge three. That way out of his comfort zone. Just watch it again. There is off the screen. Bogara coming over. There's the foul. Right before the release. So if you're Singapore, you're just glad that Thomas did not convert that free throw. But opportunity for Singapore to wrap it up right there and then. Don't find the way for it, but they're going to have to go back to the drawing board. We have a long way to go.
They definitely have to try to hit this, the next 2 free throws. right at the start of the game, he said he's going to boil down to free throws, and then truly is, they're going to hit some free throws to win the game.
So should Singapore hit one out of two, of course Bangkok will trail by three and look to reciprocate down the other end, get somebody off the screen to hit a three. They certainly have guys who are capable of doing that. Dasher, Kajeda, Giron. Firepower. So don't count these guys in green now. They are undefeated for a reason.
All right, that's it for us.
What a game. Hope you're enjoying it as much as we are bringing it to you. So here it is. Having a hard time getting the ball. And oh, he's going for the way. My goodness gracious. Go can't hold on to it. Now remember, you've only got 5 seconds to inbound the ball, so Singapore had to do something. Full court pressure by the slinger. So they need a stop.
Kajeda
in the backcourt. 10 seconds. Guevara on him. Thomas trying to clear out. He will step up. 2 seconds. Kajeda loses it. Kajeda loses it. The slinger take over. They win 77-75, and they knock Bangkok from the road to the unbeaten. Can you believe it? My goodness gracious. 16 seconds, and Bangkok can't get a sign up.
What a surprising turn on events. And the boys had to do a turnover. Defensive end, defensive pressure got to them. A turnover without even making a shot.
Shut down defense by the Slingers in the last 16 seconds. And this has been no time remaining so long. So just to make it 78-75, Wong gets the first one to me. This is the second. So now the Slingers can celebrate 78-75. They climb to 7-4, Michael Wong. Bangkok falls to 7-1.
That's a huge
psychological boost for them.
Yeah, exactly. They've cowed down, and then they coming back, working hard as a group and community. And they did it on their own reverse call. They did it on the defensive end, going, helping out on each other, getting some possessions here and there, running hard, going straight to the basket. They've been looking for each other all night long.
We'll be back to break it down in a little bit. Final score, Singapore 78, Bangkok 75. We'll be back in a little bit to break it down for you. We'll be right back.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. What a game. Dobbs Creek Singapore Singers prevail 78-75 over the previously undefeated Hi-Tech Bangkok City. Bangkok falls 7-1. The Slingers reach their record to 7-4, solidifying their position in third place, and maybe better stuff to come up in the future. They do lose Kyle Jeffers. We don't know for how long yet, but what an inspiring comeback, Michael Wong.
Yep, as we said, they did it by committee. When we look at the stats, right, 15 assists from the Singapore Slingers compared to 7 from the Bangkok Hi-Tech City. So it shows that we've been sharing the ball, we're looking out for each other. And then other stats include points off turnover. We've been really capitalizing on it, 17-7. And our points off the bench, a staggering 23-0.
Incredible stat. If you look at the rebounds, 52-36. I mean, if you didn't know better, you would think the team with 52 rebounds would easily win the game. Not so. The Singapore Singers played shutdown defense all through that final period and overtime. And there is a guy right there, Lohorn, Dior Lohorn, 35 points in this game. He really stood up when he needed to with the loss of Jeffers. He really came through. Check this out. Play of the game. Visions of Ray Allen in his head. This time it's all the way in Singapore. Dior Lohorn going beyond the three-point line. Falling back beyond the three-point line purposely. Leaning backwards and making that shot. That's what sent the game into overtime. So Singapore Slingers, although they had an 11-point lead after the injury to Kyle Jeffers, they surrendered at the comeback at the end, showed a lot of grit as we look at the standings now. Bangkok 7-1, Slingers now in second place at 7-4. Malaysia 5-3, Saigon 5-5, the Warriors, a much improved Warriors team at 3-6, and South Sumatra on the snide at 0-8. But what a great moment for the Slingers. In 3 weeks' time, we'll be back at you here from the OCBC Arena. Look at this, John Street, Singapore Slingers, and the same team. You betcha, Hi-Tech in Bangkok City. And who knows, maybe Kyle Jeffers will be well by then. We certainly hope so. We hope you enjoyed the game as much as we did bring it to you. The final score again here from the OCBC Arena. The Slingers 78, City of Bangkok, Hi-Tech 75. The Slingers now in second place. Bangkok suffering their first loss of the season. Lohorn leading the way for 35 seconds. From Michael Wong, this is Judge Reiner. We'll see you next time.